क्लास 10 मैथ सेकंड सिमिलैरिटी सब यूनिट बेसिक प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी थ्योरम इन शॉर्ट बीपीटी। स्टेटमेंट ऑफ दिस थ्योरम क्लास 10 मैथ सेकंड सिमिलैरिटी सब यूनिट बेसिक प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी थ्योरम इन शॉर्ट बीपीटी। स्टेटमेंट ऑफ दिस थ्योरम इज इफ अ लाइन पैरेलल टू अ साइड ऑफ अ ट्रायंगल इंटरसेक्ट्स द रिमेनिंग साइड्स इनटू डिस्टिंक्ट पॉइंट्स देन द लाइन डिवाइड्स द साइड्स इन द सेम प्रोपोर्शन। फ्रॉम दिस फिगर वी राइट गिवन एज इन ट्रायंगल ए बी सी लाइन एल is parallel to seg BC and line L intersects side AB and AC in point P and Q respectively. We have to prove AB upon PB is equal to AQ upon QC. For this, we have to make some construction. Draw seg PC and seg BQ. Proof: in triangle APQ, triangle APQ is here, triangle APQ, and another triangle is PBQ, PBQ. In these two triangles, vertex Q is common vertex and base of both the triangles lies in the same line. Now see this figure. In this figure, both the triangles have same common vertex, but base of these two triangles is not in the same line. So here we cannot say height of both the triangle is same. Okay, now come to this figure. In triangle APQ, base is AP, and in triangle BPQ, we take base as BP. So both the bases are in the same line and vertex Q is common vertex. So height of both the triangles is equal. And we know if two triangles have same height, then the ratio of areas of two triangles is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases. So area of triangle APQ upon area of triangle PBQ is equal to AP upon PB. Similarly, in triangle APQ and second triangle is PQC, here AQ is base of first triangle and QC is base of second triangle and point P is common vertex. So both the triangles have same height. So ratio of areas of these two triangles is equal to their corresponding bases, means AQ upon QC. Now observe two triangles, triangle PBQ and triangle PQC. Triangle PBQ is here and second triangle PQC is here. Now both the triangles have same base, that is base PQ, and here PQ is parallel to BC, so height of both the triangles is same because the perpendicular distance between two parallel lines is same. So seg PQ is common base of triangle PBQ and triangle PQC. Again, seg PQ is common base of triangle PQB and triangle PQC. And seg PQ is parallel to BC. So both the triangles have same height. Therefore, area of triangle PBQ equal to area of triangle PQC. Now look. Now, equation 1 and 2, LHS of both the equation is now equal because numerator is already equal, and now we have proved the denominator of both the ratio is now same. So we can write from 1, 2, 3, area of triangle APQ upon area of triangle PBQ is equal to area of triangle APQ upon area of triangle PQC. Therefore, from equation 1, 2 and 3, we can write AP upon PB is equal to AQ upon QC. Means these two ratios are equal, hence they are in proportion. Here we have proved for any triangle, if line is parallel to one side of a triangle and intersect this line in at two distinct points, then this line divides remaining two sides in proportion. Remember, this theorem is applied, or we can apply, only in triangle. Now come to the converse of this theorem, converse of basic proportionality theorem. Now look in the figure. In triangle ABC, here line L is intersect side AB and side AC at two distinct points, and this converse statement says, if a line divides any two sides of a triangle in the same ratio, then the line is parallel to the third side. Means in this figure, if AP upon PB is equal to AQ upon QC, then we say line L is parallel to BC. Here in the figure, line L intersect side AB and side AC of triangle ABC in points P and Q respectively, and AP upon PB is equal to AQ upon QC. Hence, line L is parallel to side BC, because here both the ratios are in proportion. Let's see one example. In triangle ABC, AP is 6 and PB is 2, AQ 9, QC 3, and here we have to find whether the line L is parallel to seg BC. In this figure, AP is 6, PB is 2, and AQ is 9, QC is 3, and we have to decide whether the line L is parallel to BC or not. So in triangle ABC, take first ratio, AP upon PB, that is 6 upon 2. After simplified, we get 3 upon 1. Now take next ratio, that is AQ upon QC, that is 9 upon 3, okay? After simplify, we get 3 upon 1. Means both the ratios are equal. So AP upon PB is equal to AQ upon QC. Therefore, by converse of basic proportionality theorem, we can say line L is parallel to seg BC. Let's see one more property, that is property of an angle bisector of a triangle. Statement of this theorem is, the bisector of an angle of a triangle divides the side opposite to the angle in the same ratio of the remaining sides. In this figure, triangle ABC is given and CE is angle bisector of angle ACB, and this bisector divides AB at point E, and the ratio of these two segments, that is AE and AB, is equal to the ratio of remaining two sides, that is AC and BC. We have to prove the ratio of remaining two sides, means AC upon CB, is equal to the ratio AE upon EB. So we write first given as, in triangle ABC, bisector of angle C intersect seg AB in the point E. We have to prove AE upon EB is equal to CA upon CB. For this, we have to make construction. Draw a line parallel to ray CE passing through point B. extend AC so as to intersect it at point D. Proof. First step of the proof. Ray CE is parallel to ray BD and AD is transversal. So angle CD, that is angle number 1, is congruent to angle ACE, corresponding angles. But angle ACE is congruent to angle ECB because this is given, that is bisector, C is bisector. Now taking BC as a transversal, we get angle ECP is congruent angle CBD. So from 1, 2, 3, we can write angle CDB is congruent angle CDB. Angle CBD, this angle CBD is congruent angle CDB. So in triangle CBD, side BC and side CD are congruent. Therefore, CB is equal to CD. Look the next step. In triangle ABD, seg EC is parallel to seg BD. Now look in this triangle ABD. In this triangle, CE is parallel to BD. So here we apply BPT and we can write here AE upon EB is equal to AC upon CD. In equation 4, already written CB, that is equal to CB is equal to CD. So replace CD by CB, that is AE upon EB is equal to AC upon CB. Hence the theorem, that is property of an angle bisector of a triangle, is proved.